Hi, Stuart Shields here with Guitar Interactive Magazine, extending our cover of NAMM 2019. I have with me the wonderful Andreas. Kissa, how are you doing, Andreas?
Good, man. Great to be here.
Yeah. How's the NAMM show treating you?
I just got here, actually. I separated, you know, this day to be here the whole day. Started here at Orange and going to different booths and, you know, to see my sponsors and people. It's a great opportunity to see everybody here, you know. Musicians, friends, and people from the business. So it's good to be here. At the same time, I have my family as well, so we're gonna enjoy a little vacation too.
Right.
It's a beautiful place, you know, to be.
Sure.
So it's good that I could put both things together. I love to be here. I'm here. I was here also for the Metal Allegiance show that was last night, you know. So it's wonderful, you know. It's great to enjoy this and to have such great partners, you know, that help us to be on the road and to do what we do.
Fantastic. How was the performance last night? Did it go well?
Oh, man, amazing. It's beyond words, actually, you know. So many people, friends and bands that inspired me to be a musician, you know, to start Sepultura, to play this kind of music. And backstage is such a great vibe, you know. No ego trips. No stupidity. You know, everybody's there to enjoy and to play, you know, our idols. We played Maiden, we played, you know, Slayer, we even play a Sepultura song, and we play Anthrax, and of course the own material for Metal Allegiance. We have two albums, you know, and it's great that Alex Koenig, David Ellison, Mike Portnoy, and Mark Menge, which are the core four, you know, who started this project. They wrote great music, and we perform a lot of our new stuff as well last night, you know. And besides having so many shows, you know, at the same time in different places, we had a great crowd, you know. It was really amazing.
Right. And is there, are there plans to do more performances, another album?
Yes, I mean, for sure. I'm gonna start to be more involved, you know, also in composition, to put my ideas and my riffs over there for our next album. We don't have any shows confirmed, but we're working very hard to bring this project to South America and different places, you know. We did a New York show as well for the release party of the second album, Power Drunk Majesty.
Great name, great name.
So, and hopefully, you know, it's very hard to put together all the musicians. Mm. Everybody has their bands and stuff, and because we are in NAMM, you know, everybody comes here for different stuff. It's easier, you know, to organize everything. But hopefully we'll have a chance to play more shows this year.
Yeah. So it's tough to marry up your schedules with so many people in other bands.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
How do you manage to organize a tour, or, you know, dates between everyone? Is it difficult?
Yeah, it's difficult, but if you have enough time in advance, anything it's possible, it's workable, you know. I have many different projects besides Metal Allegiance and Sepultura. I have a band called De La Tierra, which it's metal singing in Spanish and Portuguese. It's very interesting, you know, like different musicians as well. It's Andres Jimenez from Animal, a band from Argentina. The bass player is Harold Hopkins from Puerto Rico, from Puya. And the drummer is the drummer from Maná, from Mexico, Alex Gonzalez, you know. And we got together to play metal in Portuguese and Spanish. We have two albums. So I have a band called Kisser Clan, together with my son, Johan. He's 21 years old and he plays guitar as well, you know. He's studying music, and so he's following the steps of daddy. And so we have this band also to play covers, you know. I created kind of this band to put him on stage, you know, to show him that you need to be careful where you're gonna put your amp, you know, plug your amp to the voltage, and, you know, prepare your guitar, change the strings, be ready for the show, you know, not only the glamour and girls and all that stuff, you know, to be a professional, really, you know, to enjoy what you do, you know, because if you go on stage and do whatever, it's gonna be a disaster, not only for the crowd, but especially for yourself,
yeah.
You know. So it's great. We're gonna play at Rock in Rio this year in a very small stage they have, like, it's called Rock District. So also Sepultura will play at Rock in Rio in October. It's gonna be an amazing day, October 4th, 2019, Rock in Rio. the metal day is going to be Iron Maiden, Scorpions, Megadeth, and Sepultura, and on the main stage. And on the sunset stage, it's going to be Slayer, Anthrax, Torture Squad, and Claustrophobia, which are two Brazilian bands, together with Chuck Billy from Testament as a guest. And opening the stage is going to be Nervosa, which is a power trio from Brazil, only with women, you know, playing very aggressive, heavy music. So it's going to be a historical day, and very glad and happy we are a part of it as well.
Perfect. Thank you very much for being here.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks for your room for Sepultura.
And enjoy the rest of your show, man. Pleasure.
Thank you. Cheers.